you guys might notice something a little bit different about my room today. Sprout! Sprout! What are you doing?
Oh, Olivia, are you moving rooms? I hear you ask. Not exactly. I'm actually moving house. Yay! I am literally, I have been dreaming about making this vlog for ages, because obviously buying a house, these things take a while. So I've known for ages, and I haven't really told many people, because I wanted it to be like a little social media surprise, woo. And so that is what we're doing today, oh my god. So I've ridden all the horses this morning, I've got physio in a bit, and then the big move starts, and I wanted to film it. Because I want to document it for you guys, but also for myself, because 26 years I've been waiting for this moment. It was quite an emotional reason to why it actually came about happening. But yeah, it's time. It's time. But I will explain later about that little story, because it's a deep one. But anyway, welcome to the new house vlog. Okay, so physio is done and it's time to introduce you guys to my new home. The guy who owned it before just messaged me saying he's left. So I'm going to go around now and take a little few bits that I've put in my car. But then the main amount of furniture will be moved when my dad finishes work and my boyfriend finishes work, because they're the heavy lifters and also they can drive trailers. So at the moment I can only move little bits, but I might as well go show you it when it's empty. Let's do it. I'm literally freaking out right now, like this is insane. Obviously every time I've come to visit it, it's had all of their stuff in it, so it's just really weird like seeing it like this, like a blank canvas. This is a weird feeling. I've never felt like this in my life. I can't explain to you. It's literally my whole life feels like it's changed. I don't know why. I want to show you around, but I might add a bit of video in. Well, actually, let's do it now because it's empty. Oh, I don't know what to do. I'm just too excited. This is the kitchen. So through there is the conservatory, which is where we came through. Exciting. Oh, and obviously that's the garden, which it's raining at the moment, so let's not look at that. Okay, so this is the kitchen. Da-da-da-da. Woo! Okay, and then through here is the lounge. Exciting. Yeah, all looking very... Oh, he took the cupboard off the wall. Darn. All looking very empty. Okay, and then through here... we have a downstairs bathroom here, and then I'm just trying to find the light switches. Up here is upstairs, obviously. I haven't been up here yet, so this is the first time me seeing it empty. Okay, so in here
is going to be my office. Very exciting. And then in here is my bedroom. Let's go have a look. Ooh. Yep, so that's bedroom. And then through here is another bedroom, which will be the spare one. Oh, cool, he left the lights. Let's check these out. Apparently they're, like, you can turn them different colors. How do you turn this on? No? Oh, okay, we'll come back to that at a later date. Oh, crumbs. Okay, so yeah, wardrobes there. And then this is just a cupboard with nothing in it. Storage. And then here is my bathroom. Oh, ta-da! Bathroom.
So this is the house, and now we can start filling it up, filling my nest up. But first, shall I tell you guys about how I came to move out of home? Okay, so let's get ready for the story of how I came to move out. So it's something that I've been thinking about for a while, but I wanted to put, like, growing my business first. So I put a lot of, like, the money I was earning from that to push growing things. And then once I felt like that was kind of stable and settled, I started to save towards thinking about getting somewhere. I was thinking about maybe renting somewhere, and then I was going to maybe go into it with a family member. But what I actually found out is I could get a mortgage, and that was actually possible for me. And then I made the choice to actually go ahead and have my own home and, yeah, just get on the property ladder. So the emotional side of actually starting to do this is quite a sad one. The reason I pushed it quicker was, you know, when I had depression this year and I got really, really low, I remember there was a lot of friction between me and mum, and when I was just so upset and I wanted, like, I needed my space, I needed to kind of process what was going on, I just felt like I couldn't get away. It's because my parents were so worried about me, they were really concerned, but I just felt like I didn't have anywhere where I could go and, like, be away from anyone. And then also the other thing as well, I just felt like I couldn't grow as a person, because the reason, my circumstance is quite unique in the fact of, I know a lot of people still live with their parents at my age, but I work with my mum and I live with my mum. And that was causing quite a lot of friction in our relationship. I think to be honest, we both needed space away from each other. We both needed time by ourselves, if that makes sense. And it's very difficult when you're living together and you're kind of always under each other's feet. And I think one of the things, and this is gonna sound really, it's not meant to sound horrible, but I just felt like I couldn't grow my character individually away from my parents. I felt like a lot of choices I was making was kind of like what they wanted me to do or what they thought I should do. Same with, like, friends group, is that, like, some of my friends they weren't sure about, and then I was going, actually, am I sure about them? And then I was like, okay, why do I feel this way? Is it because of how my parents feel, or is it because of how I actually feel? And of course I'll always respect my parents' choice, but it was very difficult for me to kind of go, is it my parents or is it me? So I think, like, now I can have my own space, I'll be able to, like, grow individually more. But yeah, basically that's it. It was a lot sadder when it was going on, obviously. I mean, there was a point where my mum was literally on Right Move, trying to find places for me to rent to move out that week. She was like, you need to leave. There was a lot of friction. I'm making it sound less dramatic than it probably was. It was not an easy time for any of us. So this is, like, a massive This is just massive, like massive. Oh, I can't even put to words. I'm feeling quite emosh. I think as well, yeah, I don't know. That's it. That's all I've got to say. So anyway, I'm sure I'll blab on more in this vlog about it, but shall we start moving some stuff in? I think so. I have bought like a million candles for this house. Good job I did a firefighter. I have a feeling it's gonna take a while. Right, I'm gonna go home and get more stuff, and then hopefully my dad will be back and he can start helping me with the furniture, because I want to get the furniture in really today, and then I can do all the little bits tomorrow. Let's do this! I'm not sure I'm packing the best. At the moment, I'm making do. Also, I've got so many paintings. That's not a painting, hold on. I've got so many paintings that people have done of the horses. It's gonna fill the house. So excited. I bought these speakers in the background. Where are they? For the specific reason of jamming out in my kitchen. It starts. Okay, so my dad's arrived home, which means it's time for the furniture. So excited. Also, the kitchen table that I'm having is the one at the tack room. And it was our kitchen table when I was young. So it's got all the doodles from me when I was younger on the bottom. I'll try and show you, it's so cute. But it's like, what's the word? Nostalgic, that's it. And I sanded it the other day and linseed oiled it. So yeah, so nice, so excited. So yeah, anyway, the furniture, it's time for that. So nice as well. The Howard Pugh, who's my dad's friend, is actually who I bought the house off, and they've lent us. Oh, they've lent us their trailer to move. Because it was raining, I was scared everything was gonna get wet. So he let us borrow it. So nice. No, there's a bird shit on my stuff. Came into the house, and at the front door there was this. God works mysterious ways. I must have a Christian neighbor. Yes, I was gonna film all the moving stuff in, but I feel like it'll cause a family argument. Tom's still not here, so I'm just moving it, and then I'll update you guys once it's moved. Okay, so we're 2 hours from when I left you. The strong man turned up. So we're gonna set up the sofa. Go with you. Huh? There.
I did a really good joke and I missed it. I said nailed it. Get it?
Oh, good.
Is it nice?
Yay!
What if the lowest allows my car?
I am so tired, so we're getting a Chinese and then I'm going to sleep. And I'll start again in the morning. And I need to get some curtains.
We didn't have any wine glasses, so we're... opting for these. Also, I was thinking earlier I should have said where we got a sofa from. The sofa club. It's so great. Yay! Good morning, folks. I was awoken to a delivery of a fridge and a washing machine. Who delivers at 7 o'clock in the morning? I know that's not that early, but when you've been moving, it is. So anyway, my boyfriend, the plumber, has gone to work. So it's going to leave me to unpack the fridge, let it rest for 4 hours. And then, yeah, I don't know about the washing machine. But I feel like I should tell you where I'm getting these things from because it's going to be like a home vlog. Both the fridge and washer dryer is from AO and they're Beko. So there we go. Top tip from Towers. I don't know why I thought I could lift a fridge. I might have to wait for Dad to get here. I can't remember where I left the vlog from, but Dad came and he helped me unpack stuff. We also put a few pictures up. Well, tried to find places for them. This is the one that came all the way from Germany, which is Moly. It's so nice to have artwork in the house. It feels so special because you guys did this and it's so nice to have like a little part of you in the house reminding me how great you are. So yeah, it's just so nice. So what else was I gonna say? I am going to go with my friend Malcolm to Malvern now to look in his storage cabinet because he's got loads of furniture that he was just gonna get rid of, but he said that I can have, so that's so kind of him. So I'm gonna go and try and find a chest of drawers for my room because at the moment I don't really have anywhere to put clothes because my wardrobe, the pole in it's broken, so I can't hang things up in there. And it's just a little bit difficult. As you can see, I'm still in the same clothes. And yes, the same underwear. Was that too much information? Probably. But anyway, this is the reality of moving house. Yeah, so I need to go sort all that out so I can actually get clothes here. But I am going to go home, have a shower, change after I've done that. It's still quite early in the morning, by the way. What else was I going to say? Oh yeah, I just did an Instagram live and showed everybody the house. And a lot of people are asking if I'm bringing one of the dogs. I am. I'm bringing Lulu because she's my dog. And look what. I actually bought this for my mum as a present. And she just put it in the cellar and ignored it. So I bought it for Lulu. Isn't that the most precious thing you have ever seen? That's what I was going to tell you. The guy who delivered my sofa yesterday, I just went on my Facebook and it's like, you have a Facebook request. And I was like, who is this? And I was like, I recognize this person. How do I know this person? And I was like, oh, he delivered my sofa. Lol, he's trying to slide in the DMs. So I just got back from getting the chest drawers, took it home. It needs painting, so Dad's helping me do that. But yeah, I just got back. And there's a little letter for me. Well, a parcel. It's from Bloom and Flower. No, Bloom and Wild, which I know is flowers because I bought some from there before. So I'm gonna open it and see who it's from. Thank you, Debbie, for sending us flowers.
I didn't have another vase, so my protein to the rescue. So pretty, I love it. So I've just brought my dog round to have a look. She's quite a nervous dog because she's a rescue one. I've just seen they've left the heights on the door. So I'm just letting her have a look round. She's okay, she was more scared of the journey than she is of actually being in the house.
Come on then, pussies. Let's go upstairs, ready? Pussy Mia, ready? Go. Go on, upstairs.
Don't poop on the carpets.
Go have a look.
Go have a look. It's your home. It's your new home.
What's it going on? What's it going on?
Do not poo.
Huh? What's this? Is the bed? You know a bed? Come on, up. This where you sleep? Good girl. See, it's okay. Are you okay? It's your home. It's your home. Go.
So, I'm not sure if this is interesting or not to put in the vlog, but it's literally what I'm doing. I'm gonna unpack some of my dresses and put them in the wardrobe. So, that's what I'm doing. This was from a charity shop. I love a charity shop. It's really cool. Doesn't look cool, but it is. It's like retro-y. And this dress here, this was actually my mother's. Sexy little number. Literally, love it. Love it, love it, love it. It's good for holidays. Oh, good winter one. This is a heavy dress. It is weighty. Oh, crumbs.
Oh, goodness. Thank you, Malcolm.
So I drove home to get a tape measure because I'd gone home 3 times and kept forgetting to get one because I'd left it in my friend's car. And I was like, I'll get a vase because I've got 2 sets of flowers. And then I arrive back home and Malcolm has put a tape measure through my door, which I'd left. And I was like, oh, and he got me flowers. So now I need 3 vases. So the my protein is gonna have to carry on. So I asked the sass queen what to do about curtains because she's so good with like interior stuff. And she told me like, you should get shutters. And I was like, that's such a good idea. So I'm gonna measure the kitchen and my bedroom for shutters, and then the lounge is gonna have curtains, which she's donated me. And then I'm gonna see how much it costs, and if it's okay, I might get the office ones as well. But we're gonna see. So yeah, I'm gonna measure. I forgot I was vlogging, sorry, super tired. But my friends are coming around now to check it out, and something really exciting happened for them today. I cannot wait to see them. Lucy, tell them what happened.
She got a house.
No, to you.
I got engaged.
Show them the ring.
Ding, which bit do I look into?
Hold on,
sorry,
there you go.
It's a ruby, because I like them.
Oh, and here is the...
Hey,
we've got to go all the way up.
All the way up.
All the way up.
All the way up.
Here they are.
All the way up.
The little couple.
The couple.
The couple.
So I'm back in my parents' crib, which my mum says is home, and the other place is my house. Bless her. But this is the end of this vlog because there's going to be a part 2 because I'm about to go to a show with Molly. It's Sunday, by the way, and the last time I spoke to you was Saturday. All I did was do bits and bobs And then my friends that got engaged, we went to do a celebratory dinner at our other friend's house, and there was quite a few people there, so I just wanted to like chill out for a bit. And then this morning I've just been to Aldi, home base, got some lamps and stuff, but I can show you that in part two. But anyway, I'm gonna bid you farewell. I hope you enjoyed this vlog and stay tuned for part two.